Welcome to the honors concert of the 23rd Annual Sphinx Competition, presented by the DTE Energy Foundation. This afternoon, our three junior division laureates will be competing for a $10,000 first place prize. They will be performing with the Sphinx Honors Orchestra under the direction of Maestro Carlos Botero. We ask that you turn off all cell phones and refrain from any photographs or excessive noise during the performances. Thank you very much for your consideration. Now please welcome Maestro Carlos Botero and the Sphinx Honors Orchestra.
Thank you.
Now please welcome Maestro Carlos Botero and our first laureate, 14-year-old Esme Arias Kim from Hoffman Estates, Illinois.
Thank you.
Now, please welcome Maestro Carlos Botero and our second laureate, 14-year-old Brandon Leonard from Stone Mountain, Georgia.
Thank you.
Now please welcome Maestro Carlos Botero and our third laureate, 17-year-old Sophia Ayer from Austin, Texas. And now, Maestro Carlos Botero will hold a question and answer session. Please welcome the Maestro Botero back to the stage.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. I hope you can hear me. It's been an exciting morning for us. We have been busy preparing this program for you. So I understand that you might have some questions for us. So there are two people with microphone ready for you. Whoever is ready to ask the first question, raise your hand. You will have a hard time today running all over. So I think, there we go. There is a young gentleman over here. Good morning.
Good morning. I was going to ask, how do we determine who won?
How do we determine who won? Luckily for you, you don't have to determine who won. You have to enjoy the concert. There is a panel of juries that came from all over the world, and they have been deciding since yesterday who deserves to be first here on the stage, the three laureates that you just heard, and then among themselves, who's first, who's second, and who's third. They decide who not only play every single note perfect, but also who make more justice to the music that their composers wrote. So that's how they determine. It takes about 4 decades to realize if you can be a jury or not. So you have time. There is a question over there.
How old do you have to be to do it?
Okay. How old you have to be to participate?
Yes.
Or how old you need to be to play? You can start playing whenever you want. And actually, I'll encourage everyone to start and do as much music as you can. You will never imagine how much it will influence the rest of your lives, because it gives you opportunity to practice discipline. It gives you an opportunity to practice self-awareness and evaluate what you do and plan through a long period of time so you can accomplish the things. But as you heard, all our participants today are between 14 and 16 years old. That means that you need to be that age to be in the junior division, which is this one. And then tomorrow evening, everyone is gonna hear the senior division, that you can be a little older for that. And of course, having more years practicing. Here we go. Good morning.
How do you play the right tune?
That's a very good question. How do we actually know what they're going to play? How do we play the right tune? If you can see every stand for them, for our orchestra, they have their parts. And my stand has the full score. I have all the parts together. So a composer spent several years perfecting what they wanted the tune to sound like. And then so it gave us this sheet music, and then we play from there. We need to understand what they wanted, and then we can play it together. But of course, nobody comes here just improvising something. They have to announce well in advance what they're gonna play.
I was wondering if any of you have ever had a bassoonist in your orchestra or played bassoon?
Okay, so just a question for you, just to make sure. Do you play bassoon? Okay. A symphony orchestra is comprised by every family of instruments: strings, woodwinds, brass, and percussion. The pieces that we ask these participants to play today in the competition only require the two oboes and the two French horns that you see in the back. So we did not need a bassoon. Unfortunately, Mozart didn't write it, or any composer wrote it for bassoon. But in a symphony orchestra, I see a bassoon almost every day. It needs to be part of the orchestra because it's part of the woodwind family. One more question, G. Oh, did you regret your early decision? Okay. Please ask every question. It's more important for me to know what you want to know. Good morning.
Good morning. Have you heard it? How long have you been instructing?
I did not understand the question. How long can we?
How long have you been conducting?
Oh, I have been doing this for 16 years now, conducting an orchestra. Before that, I used to play in orchestras. And I will not, I will try not to tell you my age, but I have been making music for 35 years. So by now, I am way too old. Well, I only need to see this room and so much youth and energy. I wish I had that same one. Okay, there's one more question.
Okay, my question is, how did the three people get chosen?
Oh, okay, I was answering earlier. Yesterday, we have a semifinal round. And then we heard nine people. Was it eight or nine? Somewhere there. But everyone that wanted to participate auditioned, sending a recording. And all those recordings were heard last month. Yesterday, the people selected for the semifinal, which is eight or nine, I don't remember it right now, they participated in front of the jury, just themselves and a piano. And then the three people that we call the finalists, the ones that you heard today, they are participating today. But each of them have been playing for years and years in order to make it here.
Okay. Do y'all do singing competitions?
Do we make singing? Okay, so you want to be in TV, I see. Do we make singing competitions? As far as I am participant of this, this is a competition for string instruments. That means that it's violin, viola, cello, and double bass. Tomorrow, for instance, in the senior division, we're gonna hear a viola, a cello, and a double bass. I haven't heard of the intention of making a singing competition, but as soon as we do, I will tell you first.
What was the age?
Oh, look at this. They want a choir competition. Let's do this side first, and then we go there. One second.
What was the age of the youngest competitor to ever compete in this competition?
The one that was yesterday, there was one that was 12 years old.
Wow.
Yeah. So you still have some time to practice. Very good.
I got a question. Who made violins?
I know you have a microphone, but because everyone was making noise, I could not hear you. Would you repeat your question, please?
Who made violins?
Who makes them? The profession of making violins is called a luthier. And it's a French word that means the person that makes instruments. It's as simple as that. They have to dedicate their whole life in order to make good instruments. So each of the instruments that you see here, I'm pretty sure it took about 2 years to be made. But we cannot make them because it requires really a lot of skill and craft and in itself art in order to make it. So there's so many hands over here. We're gonna, over there.
When you start being a musician?
When did I start being a musician? I have this theory. At home, they tell me that I was born being a musician. And actually, all of you are. You make noises, you like rhythm, you realize when something is high, when something is low, but more special and more important, you connect emotions to music. That already makes you a musician, when you can connect emotions to music. The difference is that I decided to be a professional musician, but that only happened when I was 17 years old and I had to decide what to do with my life. I wanted to be everything. I wanted to be a lawyer, an engineer, a doctor, and then I also wanted to be a musician. And I thought, and this is just me, if I didn't start early, I was not going to be a good one. So I decided when I was 17 to become a professional musician. But I have been playing instruments since I was 8. And then for the last 16 years, I have been conducting. I hope answers your question. One more.
How long would it take for everybody to learn the songs that they play today?
That's a very good question. So technically, they received the music about a month before our first rehearsal yesterday. The rehearsal took about 2 hours, and this morning we tuned up details for another hour. So technically, it took 3 hours to put it together. But that it is not the full picture. They have been practicing for years before the moment that we started rehearsing. So even though together it only takes, or it took 3 hours for this concert, I would add each of us playing for 20 years every single day for several hours in order to be sure that in 3 hours we can have a concert. So that is the answer. One more.
Do young kids be in competitions too?
Of course, young kids are in competitions. But more important than being in competition is that every single time you pick up your instrument, you're in a competition with yourself. That is the big difference when you practice a sport. Normally in sports, you need to be against someone, or you are supposed to be better than someone. When you make music, you're supposed to be better than yourself half an hour ago, 2 hours ago, 1 year ago. So it's a competition every single time. Trust me, sometimes it really feels very heavy competition with yourself, but the important thing is not to be in competitions. The important thing is to realize what is it that you want to be and what you want to do, and you dedicate your life to that. And then you will be successful, I promise.
How do you guys choose and pick up your music?
That was so good of a question, everyone clapped. Can you repeat your question, please?
How do you guys choose and pick out your music?
How do we pick the music? Actually, we were told what to play. That's what happens with an orchestra. We are so good at this. We sit down and they tell us what to play. The idea was that the participants can show how good they are with the music that we ask them to do. So in general, for violin, when you are between 14 and 17 years old, if you can play a Mozart violin concerto, then that means that you can be really good at it. So that's how we pick the music, how good the piece is and how good a player can be seen playing that piece. That is the selection process.
All right.
It's your first time with a microphone, I see.
Yeah, no. I wanted to know, where are you originally from?
Where I am from?
Yes.
We did this exercise with the orchestra. I asked them where they were from, and it was surprising to me how incredibly large this country is, because everyone came from different areas. Some of them really like the state of Ohio, so they really go there for a long time. And some of us came from Texas. I was born in Colombia, which is a country in South America. It is... I brought them all. They are my family. But, so I was born in Colombia.
Do you play any strings instruments?
I did. I started playing violin, and then later on, my hand decided that it was too cumbersome for me to play violin, so I switched to viola. And I play viola for several years. I have an extended family, all of this. So I did used to play string instruments.
Which of these pieces was your favorite to conduct and why?
That is a very good question, and I'm glad because it's the last question we have time for. My favorite piece, and I tell you this honestly, is the one that I'm right now doing. That is my favorite piece. I cannot choose, with so wonderful music, one that represents everything that I am. So when we started with the Piazzolla, that was my favorite piece. And then when we have Mozart, it's incredible to see how marvelous is the mind of a composer. So Mozart is my favorite piece when I'm doing it. And then later on with the Boccherini, that's my favorite piece. Why? Because each of them touches a part of me inside that makes me richer and makes me better. So that's why I cannot pick one. They all, as long as they're good music, they will be my favorite. But then I was told I have to stop. Thank you very much for your time. Now we give space for the competition.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Andre Dowell, Chief of Artist Engagement for the Sphinx Organization.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. There we go. Thank you. Thank you so much for being here today, and I hope you love hearing those amazing young artists as much as I did. They were all amazing, and it brings the Sphinx Organization great joy to see so many young people in the audience today. I want to acknowledge our host, the Detroit Symphony Orchestra, for welcoming us into their beautiful home and giving us this opportunity to share music together. Thank you to Maestro Botero and the Sphinx Honors Orchestra, and thank all of you for being a great audience. It's always great to see so many students in here, and I want you all to give yourselves a round of applause as well. We truly hope that you will continue to be inspired and surround yourself with the arts, and we look forward to seeing you and who you become, and maybe if you'd like, you'll have the same opportunity to stand on this stage like our three junior finalists. Speaking of the junior finalists, please give the biggest standing applause possible and help me bring back to the stage of Orchestra Hall the three junior division finalists of the 23rd competition, the president of Sphinx, Apa Dworkin, and our awards presenters.
Thank you guys for being such a spectacular audience. I know you've all been waiting for this moment, so I will make you wait no longer. With great pleasure, I am asking you to give a big round of applause and help me welcome to the stage Lisa Gonzalez, the Manager of Community Relations from the Ford Motor Company Fund, who makes this concert possible.
Good afternoon. I am so delighted to be here with you today at the 2020 Sphinx Competition Honors Concert. These young artists perform exceptionally, and they truly deserve our support and our recognition. Sorry. So it is my pleasure to introduce the second and third place awards for the junior division of the Sphinx competition. This is the third place winner, Sophia Ayer. And the second place winner for the junior division of the Sphinx competition is Brandon Leonard.
And finally, it is now with great pleasure that I'm asking for the biggest round of applause for Vice President of the Detroit Pistons, Aaron Tellem, who will present our very first place winner award.
I don't think there's much surprise left, but good afternoon, everyone. I'm honored to be here on behalf of the Detroit Pistons. And whether you're Blake Griffin or Derrick Rose or a great musician, it takes incredible dedication and commitment and practice to be a great athlete or one of the great musicians that's up here on the stage today. So let's give them another round of applause and recognize them. As far, for me, it was truly inspiring and moving. It was an honor for me to be here. You all are winners in my mind. For the Pistons, it is a great partnership with Sphinx. We're honored to be their partner and support this event. And with that, the first place award goes in the 2020 Sphinx Competition Honors Concert to Esme Arias Kim.
Congratulations to all of our laureates, a big thank you to our awards presenters, and thank you all for being such a fabulous audience. We will see you tomorrow.